The next one on my list is the Deputy Minister for Foreign Affairs of Turkey. The floor is yours.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. I wish to thank our hosts for this successful organization of the Ministerial Council. There has been quite a number of challenges throughout this year. As it stands, a good part of these will sadly carry over to 2018 next year. But since Turkey reiterated its principal positions several times on the issues and threats, including protracted conflicts, political and religious extremism, terrorism, proliferation of weapons of mass destruction, trafficking in drugs and human beings, as well as cyber attacks, massive influx of persons fleeing from warfare and destruction, I prefer to focus on a sole topic, namely terrorism. Although we all seem to agree that terrorism is a common threat, yet our actions often fall short of our words. More worrying is the fact that we are displaying a selective approach when it comes to fighting against terrorist organizations. Either they are all bad and are dealt with accordingly, or we will ultimately fail. The terror group FETÖ, which organized and perpetrated the coup attempt last year, is a new generation threat with a global network. It is well hidden under seemingly innocent structures, but its nature is the same, no matter what form it presents itself under. Unfortunately, affiliates of this organization were allowed a presence in these rooms as recently as last month. This happened despite our timely warnings. It is simply unacceptable. We have a clear guiding rule in the Helsinki Declaration, disallowing terrorist affiliates from participating in the meetings. But we were told that there is no consensus on how to apply these rules. So anyone can come and go to our meetings at their leisure. Simply, this is not serious. Every respectable organization, international organizations, has procedures and modalities that reflect the will and serve the interest of their members. The OSCE does as well, but these rules have not been implemented. We will welcome efforts to resolve this problem. We expect tangible results as soon as possible. We need to develop effective and clear rules to govern external participation in the OSCE's meetings. There are many best practices, such as the non-objection criteria used by other leading international organizations, that we can take inspiration from. I want to be very frank. Turkey will look to see a concrete and satisfactory outcome of ongoing efforts to develop modalities of participation in the OSCE's meetings. This should be done so by the time of our discussion on the modalities of the next Human Dimension Implementation Meeting. Otherwise, we will not be in a good position to agree to having such meetings in the future, and we will also consider other precautions within necessary within the OSCE. Mr. Chair, I certainly agree with the importance of connectivity projects. It is very relevant to Turkey, such as bridges, pipelines, railways. We encourage all OSCE members to be in good coordination with Turkey. I reiterate our congratulations to Austria for the successful chairmanship, and I wish success for the incoming chair, Italy. Thank you.